Hi guys, this is Srinivasa once again for you. Today I want to teach you the very important concept in game theory, that is dominance property or dominance principle. Already game with LPP is uploaded. Now this is the time to discuss about a dominance property. So we have a players like player A and player B. So having the four strategies for player A and the four strategies for player B. So now we are going to find the saddle point and the value of the game by using the dominance principle. So we have some sort of a procedure for calculating saddle point. First you have to find row minimum. So the row minimum from 3 to 4 is 0. The row minimum again 2. The row minimum again 0 and 1 more. The row minimum is 0. After that, column maximum. The column maximum is 4, again 4, again 4, and the column maximum is 8. We have a maximum of minimax procedure, that is max of mini is equal to mini of max. So which implies, so the maximum of. So what is minimum? So minimum is row minimum. We have 0, 2, 0 and 0. In the same way we have minimum of, so the maximum means all of you, all fours together and a single entry. So here we go. The maximum from these two is 2, which is equal to, the minimum is 4. So obviously 2 is not equal to 4. Hence the given game does not possess any saddle point. Now we are going to apply the dominance principle to make this 4x4 matrix into 2x2 matrix. So for dominance property you have to apply two procedures. The first one is the row concept, the row comparison, and the second one is column comparison. So the row comparison, the notation is, if all the elements in first is less than or equal to all the elements in second row, that is if R1 less than or equal to R2, then delete R1. And the column is C1 greater than or equal to C2. All the elements in the first one greater than or equal to all the elements in the second column, then delete C1. So this is a game without a saddle point. So that's why we are applying dominance principles straight away. So I want to, so right now we are going to apply the first step, that is row comparison. You just see here the row comparison. I'm going to compare R1 less than or equal to R2 or more. You just see here the R1 is this one. 3 is less than 3. We are going to compare the first row with the second row, right? 3 is less than 3. No, less than R equal, right? So obviously 3 equal to 3. 2 is less than 4. 4 is, but 4 is not less than 2. So obviously C1 less than C2 is not satisfied here. Now we will move on to take a part, and that is R1 less than or equal to R2. R1 less than or equal to R2. So all of it is the first row less than or equal to all the elements in the third row. We are going to compare R1 and R2. There we go. 3 is less than 4. This is R1. This is R3. So 3 is less than 4. 2 is equal. And again 4 is equal. And 0 also equal. So clearly all of you, R1 is less than or equal to R3. Then what you have to do? Delete R1. Okay, when we are going to delete R1 means we have to delete the first row. Why? Because R3 is dominating. So clearly R1 less than or equal to R3, that is delete R1. So with the loss of generality, I am going to delete the first row. The remaining, that is 3, 4, 2, 4, 4, 2, 4, 0. And the last one we have 0, 4, 0, 8. So we have R1 is deleted, we have R2, R3 and again R4. Let us assume the strategies A1, A2, A3 as R2, R1, R3 like that. So that the columns B1, B2 can be written as C1, C2, C3, C4. For the column point of view, we are representing in place of B1, B2, B3, for C1, the column C1, C2, C2. Now we are going to check out the column operation C1 greater than C2 or not of you. So 3 is greater than 4, no, 3 is not at all greater than 4. Obviously, the first condition is does not stand. Now we will move on to C1 greater than equal to C3. All the elements in the first column greater than equal to all the elements in the third column or not. Here we go. 3 is greater than 2. 4 more equal, we have equality here, right? And again, 0 is equal to 0. Clearly, C1 greater than C3. So, C1 greater than C3, we have to delete C1. So, we are going to delete the C1 column. So when I'm going to delete the C1 column is we have 4, 2, 4, again 2, 4, 0, and again 4, 0, 8. We have this. Clear? So all of you, the row operation is applied here, and again column operation also applied here. Now for this again we have going to go for a row operation here. We have R2, R3, and again R4. So the row operation of you, R2 less than equal to R3 or not, we are going to check it out here for this. 4 is not less than 2, so clearly this condition does not satisfy. We will move on to R2 less than equal to R4 or not. 4 equal, but 2 is not less than 0, minus 2, so this is also not applicable. Now we will move on to R3 less than equal to R2 or not. 2 is less than 4, yes, but 4 is not less than 2, this is also not applicable. Now we will move on to, any guesses? R3 less than equal to R4. 2 is less than 4, but 4 is not less than 0, so this is also not applicable. Now we move on to R4. Now we are going to compare R4 with R2. So clearly 4 equal, 0 is less than 2, but 8 is not less than 4 R2. This is also not applicable. Now finally we have R4 less than or equal to R3. 4 is not at all less than 2. So the row operation is, row comparison is not possible here. Now again we will move on to the column operation. It's a bit tricky problem for you. It's a tricky problem for you. Now we can move on to the column. So C1 we deleted, right? C2, C3 and C4 we are going to check out. The notation C2 greater than equal to C3 or not. 4 is greater than 2, yes, but 2 is not greater than 4. One more. C2 is greater than equal to C4. 4 equal. 2 is greater than 0, but 4 is not greater than 8. My word. This is also not applicable. And one more. C3 greater than equal to C2 or not. 2 is not greater than 4. C3 greater than equal to C4. 2 is not greater than 4. This is also not applicable. Now we move on to C4. I'm going to compare C4 with C2. So 4 equal. I mean 0 is not greater than 2. This is also not applicable. And the last chance we have, C4 is greater than equal to C3. Just see here, 4 is greater than 0, but 0 is not greater than 4. And the row operations and the column operations are also not satisfied here. Now we will move on to the combination of rows and the combination of columns. Here we go. That's why I said it's a bit tricky problem for you. Success required patience. Be patient. Here, there we go. The comparison, I'm going to compare the first row with the combination of, I mean to say, the second row. You just focus here. I'm doing this one only. So R2 with the combination of R3 and R4. So the notations are of you, R2 less than or equal to R3 plus R4 by 2. This is all about the notation. What is R2? 4, 2, 4 is less than or equal to R3 plus R4. 2 plus 4, 6. 6 by 2, 3. 4 is less than 3? No. So this is also not applicable here. Now I'm going to compare R3 with the combination of R2 and R4. So the notation is R3 less than or equal to R2 plus R4 by 2. Clearly? So here we go. What is R3? R3 is 240. 240 is less than or equal to 4 plus 4, 8 by 2. 8 by 2 again 4. So 2 is less than 4. Okay. 2 plus 0, 2 by 2, 1, but 4 is not less than 1. So this is also not applicable here. So the combination for R3 is also not applicable. Now we will move on to R4 applications. R4 is less than or equal to R2 plus R3 by 2. Last chance we have. One more. Here we go. So R4 means 4. R4 means 4, 0, 8 is less than or equal to R2 plus R3, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 by 2 is 3. So this is also not at all applicable, my students. No, so the combinations are not at the left atrium, right? Be patient. This is what we call operation. We are going to compare C2 is greater than or equal to C3 plus C4 by 2. The column comparisons. So the C2 means 4 to 4 is greater than or equal to C3 plus C4, 2, 2 plus 4, 6 by 2, 6 by 2 is 3, 4 plus 0, 4 by 2, again 2, 0 plus 8, 8 by 2, that is 4. You just check out here of you, 4 is greater than 3, 2 is equal and 4 also equal, all of you, C2 is deleted. So the common is, so the row operation are not possible, call margins also, the call comparison also not possible, the combinations are also not possible here, but only the column combinations are possible here. So C2 is deleted. Now we are gonna delete the C2, that we have 2, 4, 4, 0, again we have 0, 8. Why? Because C2 is deleted, so the column C2 is deleted, we have this one. Clear? So the column operations are also over. Now we will move on to again the row operation again. The comparison. Our aim is to make this matrix into 2 by 2. Clear? So again I am going to compare now. So that is R2 less than or equal to R3. 2 is less than 4, but 4 is not less than 0. For whatever it is. R2 less than or equal to R4. 2 is not less than 0. This is also not possible. And again, R3 less than or equal to R2 or not. 4 is not less than 2. 0 is also not. 0 is less than 4, but 4 is not less than. So, and again, R3 less than or equal to R4. 4 is not at all less than 0. And the column operation we are not applying here. Our aim is to make this matrix as 2 by 2, finally. So if we're going to apply the column operation, one column we have to delete, right? So we have to go for a combination of rows once again. Be patient, the combination of rows. So here we go. R2 less than or equal to what we did just now. So what is R2? 2 and 4 less than or equal to R3 plus R4. That is 4 plus 0, 4 by 2, 2. 2 is less than 0 plus 8, 8 by 2. So clearly of you, 2 is equal and 4 is also equal. Hence the combination is applicable here. What we have to do? We have to delete R2. So when we are going to delete R2, then the remaining matrix is, then the remaining matrix after we have deleted, then the remaining matrix is 4, 0 and 0, 8. 4, 0 and 0, 8. So this is all about, this is all about 18 and this is for A4. If you observe the question, we will get all these things. 4, 0 means this is all about B3 and again B4. So we have a mixture strategies for player A. Let us assume this is like A11, A12, A21, A2. Then the mixture strategies for player A is SA is equal to, we have A3, A4, P3, P4, and the mixture strategy for player B is, so we have B3, B4, right? So that is B3 and B4, this is Q3 and again Q4. The formula for P3 is A22 minus A21 by A11 plus A22 minus A21 plus A12. So here, what is A22? That is 8 minus A21 means 0 by A11 plus A22. This is A1, this is A22. That is 4 plus 8 minus 0 plus 0. So the value is all of you 8 by 8. So 8 plus 4. For this is 4 by 6. This can be written as 2 by 3. This is P3. The formula for P4 is 1 minus P3, which is equal to 1 minus 2 by 3. This is again 1 by 3. This is the mixer strategy for player A. Now we will want to the mixer strategy for player B. The mixer strategy for player B is SB. SB, the same the notation for the mixer strategy for player B, that is Q3, the same formula, only thing is a22 minus a12 bar the same notation a11 plus a22 minus a21 plus a1. So that is, what is a22? The value of a22 is 0. So take a part in k minus a12 is again 0, and the denominator is same for each and every cases, then obviously 8 by 12 which is equal to 2 by 3. And the formula for Q4 is 1 minus Q3 which is equal to 1 minus 2 by 3 again 1 by 3. So we calculate mixture strategy for play area and mixture strategy for play area. Finally, on Q, value of the game. The value of the game V is equal to the easiest ever A11 A22 minus A21 into A12 bar. The same formula here, all you have to do is you have to add A11 plus A22 minus A21 plus A1. So which is equal to what is A11? 4 times of 8 minus 0 into 0 by 4 plus 8 of 0 plus 0. That is 32, which is equal to 32 by 12. So, which is equal to 16 by 6, 8 by 3. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Thank you.